Who were the 12 Olympians? This mighty group of Greek gods takes its name from Mount Olympus, where the Council of 12 gathered to discuss issues. They were a family, with brothers and sisters making up the majority of the group and their firstborn children making up the rest. There were two more gods that weren't given this title, and we'll discuss that too during the latter part of this video. But first, let's dive into the story of the credited ones. Zeus. As the king of all gods, Zeus oversaw the other gods who resided on the sacred mountain after winning the war against Cronus. He was the last arbiter of justice and law, possessing authority over both the earth and the heavens. He had complete control over the weather and enforced his rule by unleashing bolts of lightning and thunder. One of the Titan sisters named Metis was Zeus's first bride. Despite having a wandering eye and a propensity for flings with any and all women, he later married his own sister, Hera. Numerous more gods, demigods, and mortal heroes on Earth were born from his affectionate interests. Hera. She ruled as queen of the gods, goddess of marriage, women, the sky, and the stars of heaven. She was one of only two Olympians who remained continuously true to her spouse. Ironically, because Zeus was the complete opposite. As the goddess who oversaw marriage, she punished any women who had extramarital relationships with Zeus, as well as their children. Io was one of them, who was transformed into a cow, and Hera sent a gadfly to constantly torment her. She had Artemis hunt for her after transforming Callisto into a bear. She misled Semele into requesting Zeus to display his whole magnificence before her, which resulted in the unfortunate mortal woman's death at the sight of it. Heracles, the son of Zeus and Alcmene, became the target of Hera's enmity. She set up his 12 labors in the hope that he wouldn't survive, sent snakes to poison him in the cradle, and sent the Amazons after him when he entered their territory. Poseidon. The cosmos was divided among Zeus and his two brothers when he ascended to the throne. Poseidon was granted control over all the world's oceans and waterways. He had the ability to cause earthquakes, floods, and storms. He was also the deity of horses and the guardians of sailors, and they pushed his chariot over the waves. His own majestic team of horses mixed with the sea foam. Although Poseidon was prone to wandering away, he shared a magnificent mansion with his wife, Aphrodite. She was equally forgiving as Hera, and used magic plans to transform Scylla, one of Poseidon's lovers, into a monster with 6 heads and 12 feet. Poseidon also had a bad reputation for raping the chaste beauty Medusa. Demeter. Humans revered her as the good goddess, and she was in charge of agriculture, farming, and the fertility of the land. Persephone, one of Demeter's daughters, grabbed the attention of Zeus's third brother, Hades. He eventually kidnapped the girl and took her to his dreary subterranean mansion. Demeter was so upset that she ignored her responsibilities and scoured the entire planet for her daughter. Zeus finally gave Hades the order to return his gift, since the ensuing starvation killed so many people and devoured the entire globe. But crafty Hades tricked Persephone into consuming pomegranate seeds from the underworld, binding her to the underworld for all time. Persephone agreed to spend 6 months of every year with Hades after they reached a compromise. Demeter is so grieved about Persephone's absence over those 6 months that nothing can grow, causing each year's winter. Athena. Zeus had a relationship with a Titan named Metis before he wed Hera. Everything was going well until a prophecy was delivered to Zeus that predicted one of the two children he would have with Metis would overpower him, just as he had done with Cronus. Zeus persuaded Metis to change into a fly so that they wouldn't have offspring, and then he ate the fly. Zeus started having excruciating headaches, and Hephaestus, son of Hera, had to hit him with an axe, which led Zeus to vomit out Athena. The power of Athena was equal to that of any other god. She chose to stay a virgin and refused to take any lovers. She assumed her position as the goddess of justice, tactical warfare, insight, reason, and the craftsmanship on Mount Olympus. One of her most significant emblems was the owl, when she gave the first olive tree to her beloved namesake city of Athens as a gift. Artemis. Zeus, in his affair with the Titaness Leto, produced Artemis and Apollo, who were twins. Hera extended Leto's labor to continue a full 9 months and threatened every nation in the globe with a horrible curse if they provided refuge. The twins were as unlike from one another as night and day. Yet, despite all of that, they were born and went on to become significant Olympians. Artemis was the goddess of the moon, woods, archery, and hunting. She was calm, dark, and gloomy. Like Athena, she too had no desire to be married. She was closely related to wild animals and was the patron goddess of female purity, childbirth, and fertility. Apollo. Apollo. He was the god of the sun, light, music, prophecy, medicine, and wisdom. His oracle at Delphi was the most well-known in the ancient Earth. The lyre that Apollo won from his mischievous younger brother Hermes was forever associated with the god. Of all the gods, Apollo was regarded as the most attractive. He was bright and upbeat, loved to sing, dance, and drink, and was adored by both gods and humans. He imitated his father's pursuit of mortal women as well, but not always with great success. Aphrodite. The Olympian goddess of love, sexual pleasure, beauty, and fertility is Aphrodite. Few of the goddess's children, the Erotes, who are capable of igniting passion in both humans and gods at the goddess's command, routinely accompany her. She is portrayed as being both voracious and unreachable, and birthed from the foam Uranus's castrated genitalia made as they fell into the sea. She had a relationship with every Olympian except Zeus and Hades while being married to Hephaestus. The one with Ares, the god of battle, was perhaps the most renowned. She also had well-known relationships with two mortals, Anchises and Adonis. Ares. In stark contrast to his sister Athena, Ares was the god of battle. He enjoyed the slaughter and violence that battle brought forth. With the exception of Aphrodite, all the other Olympians hated him for his violent attitude and quick temper, and mortals felt the same way about him. Although he had a far lesser following than other gods and goddesses, the warlike Spartans of southern Greece greatly worshipped him. And despite being associated with battle, he is frequently painted as a coward who flees to Olympus at the first sign of injury. Hermes. As the god of commerce, thieves, and travel, Hermes possessed a remarkably varied range of abilities. He is also always shown as being mischievous and always looking for pleasure and excitement. When he was a little child, he stole livestock from Apollo's holy herd, and as retribution, he was stripped of his lyre. Hermes served as the god's messenger and completed a variety of tasks, such as killing the monster Argos to liberate Io, liberating Ares from gigantic captivity, and persuading Calypso to release Odysseus and his men from her control. He also had a responsibility to lead souls into the afterlife. Dionysus. He was a popular deity among both Olympians and mortals since he was the god of wine, fun, theater, and ceremonial insanity. The princess of Thrace named Semele, whom Hera duped into asking to see Zeus in all his splendor, gave birth to Dionysus. Zeus saved Semele's unborn child by stitching him into his thigh, but Semele could not endure the revelation. A few months later, Dionysus was born from that thigh and was looked after by the Nysa nymphs. He was the only Olympian to have a mortal mother, which may have contributed to why he spent so much time with mortal men, traveled far, and gave them wine. Hestia. The last of Zeus's sisters, Hestia, is frequently left out of the list of the 12 Olympians who make up the classical pantheon. Hestia guarded the house and the hearth and was the kindest of all the goddesses. She was known for gladly relinquishing her throne to Dionysus when he was born, claiming that she was happier sitting next to and taking care of the fire that warmed Olympus. Now for the final part. In the majority of legendary Greek tales, Aphrodite's husband, Hephaestus, was not a member of the council, and neither was Hades as he lived in the underworld instead of Mount Olympus. And with this, we have covered the 12, or presumably 14 Olympians from Greek mythology. If you enjoyed watching this video, make sure you hit the like and subscribe button so you don't miss out on our future uploads. We'll see you next time. Until then, stay mythical!